And we're back. How's it going, everybody? Thanks for tuning in. Coming at you today with Jazz Mountain Journey number 3 of the new series, live from the Jam Cave Studios, deep in the heart of the Jazz Mountain. I've got my two co-hosts here, Prince Caspian and Reba, going to help me out here today, and we're going to take you on a ride into the unknown. We've been busy, but the sage is back. We've had enough time to kind of listen to some things and compile a really good list of songs for you today. Like always, we don't really know what we're going to play or how it's going to go, but we're going to take some chances and we're going to delve deep into the archives here to jam out some good stuff. And without further ado, I think we should get it going, right? I got this box set vinyl not too long ago in the mail, and I'm really pumped about it. So we're going to start off with a hot track off there. And in fact, today I figured out something. I kind of jimmy-rigged everything with my setup here to be able to play vinyls through my computer. So a lot of the songs today, guys, are going to be straight from the vinyl shelf. So we'll see if you can tell the difference with the sound quality. I think I can. It's a little fresher, a little hotter, and a little cleaner. And anyway, the vibe is just cooler when you got the vinyl spinning. So we're going to do a bunch of that today, including this first one here from King Gizzard and the Lizard Wizard, one of my favorite bands these days. So check it out. Let's get it going, baby. We'll be right back.
Yeah.
That was live from Red Rocks Amphitheater in 2022. Song is called Boogeyman Sam, which is one of my favorites by them for sure. It's actually track one, side one on the album Fishing for Fishies, which is amazing. Check it out if you ever get the chance. And you gotta love the harmonica at the end of that one. It just creates such a raucous, fun vibe. And you know, the jam is kind of different, you know, like they're pretty unique in that way. They don't really jam like another jam band. And in fact, they're not really even a jam band. They just kind of are a rock band that extends songs and has fun. And I was reading an article not too long ago where Trey Anastasio from Phish was quoted as saying, in reference to King Giz, "It feels so loose and all about the hang, which is the way I came into music, jamming with friends, trying things out and not getting too precious. I always just wanted to be with my friends jamming, and I get that same vibe from King Giz. I immediately fell in love with them and could relate." So yeah, I kind of get that same idea that Trey has. You know, they're just kind of out there to have fun and just rage. And whatever you get, you get. And you never know where it's going to take you, but it's going to be a good time. And they're coming to St. Louis in September. So all y'all St. Louis people tuning in, get ready for that one. And let's keep it going here with another vinyl from the archives. I'm picking this one by Grant Green, guitar jazz great. It's from the album Alive. And the song is called Suki Suki. Let's check it out. Oh, of the most underrated guitar players of his era. That's Grant Green and his sextet from 1970. Gotta love how that one's like the perfect blend of chill and funky there from the album Alive. And yeah, he was basically not really recognized or appreciated as much as he should have been, but now we realize how amazing he was and how much influence he had on music. And that one puts me in the mood for this next one by sax player Cannonball Adderley, who was one of the two sax players on the iconic Miles Davis record Kind of Blue. But this track is quite a bit different than that record in the sense that it's very extended and trippy and psychedelic, and he's actually the band leader. And I found this one in the discount rack underneath the main shelves at Vintage Vinyl Records in St. Louis here. And I got it for like $10. And to be honest, it's one of the best purchases I've made in recent history. And first time I spun this one, I knew it was special. So let's get it going here again with a 15-minute jam from Cannonball Adderley. So strap in and get ready for a little trip here, guys. We're going big and we're going deep. This one's called The Black Messiah, title track on the album.
Welcome to the first show here at the Troubadour this evening.
My name is Rick Holmes. We represent the melodic lyrical powerful side of the Clearscope on your jazz station in Southern California. And that's Rick's affair. Good evening. Thank you. This coming March, I will celebrate 10 years in radio. And I've met a lot of people, and I love all the artists in the business, but there's always one who is closer and deeper than the others. He happens to be a man that I truly love. My man, Cannonball Adderley, the leader of this group, ladies and gentlemen. Let's get it on now.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Yeah. Thank you to Cannibal Adderley and the boys for that mystical jam right there. And we're going to keep it going here on Jazz Mountain via the 3 p.m. request line. So I texted my good buddy Nick Lou Luking what he wanted to hear this afternoon. And he quickly texted back, I want to hear some MMSW, which to me means Medeski, Martin, Schofield, and Wood. I saw them one time way back in the day, like in high school in Milwaukee, and it blew me away. They're an amazing group, and actually, this one is not going to come from the famed first release by the band, A Go-Go, which I guess is actually just a John Schofield record, but this one is going to be from 2014 from a record I just found out about a couple days ago called Juice, and this track is North London, so here we go. We'll be right back.
Let's make this a democratic process. How would you like to have this song end? One at a time. With a boogie. Wait a minute, just a minute, just so that we won't be inadequately represented here. We have one side that says it should end with a boogie. Does anybody want to have it end with a ballad? Okay, we have some other people want to have it end with a ballad. How many want to have it end with a march? How many want to have it end with a polka? How many would like to have it end with a dog food jingle? Well, let's see. So far, it looks like it's a choice between the boogie and the ballad. Contestant number one would be the boogie. How many say boogie? How many say ballad? Well, guess what it ends with? We'll be right back.
MMSW into some Frank Zappa right there. And I've delved pretty deep into the Frank Zappa catalog here recently because my new girlfriend really likes Zappa because she likes weird music and I like jams. And it's kind of like a perfect combination of the two. So we've listened to a lot of stuff, including that last one called DC Boogie off of the live album Imaginary Diseases. And I kind of have a love-hate relationship with that song, you know. The boogie they choose to, you know, finish the song and bring the house down is awesome. But like, come on, I'm a dog food jingle kind of guy. I would have been yelling for that. Like, when Frank Zappa asks you how he wants to end the song and offers dog food jingle, how is that not the number one answer? I just don't know what that is. And like, he's so weird and such a freak that like, I'm sure that would have been amazing. But, you know, they chose the boogie. So I will always be left wondering what the dog food jingle is. But I guess that's the mystery of life that makes life interesting. Anyway, we're going to go into something different here, guys. We're going to change it up and go with some straight jazz. So Freddie Hubbard is one of my favorite band leaders, kind of like Miles Davis. He's a trumpet player who's unbelievable at trumpet, but like he just has really good bands and really good vibes, and he's a great writer of music and a great organizer of sound. And this one's called High Blues Pressure, title track off the album. Here we go. Thank you. We got time for one more in the first set here for you tonight, y'all. And it's going to be by the band Traffic off of the album John Barleycorn Must Die. And that album name has a little bit of significance for your host here. First of all, it was the name of this really crappy 5 a.m. bar in Chicago, John Barleycorn. And we were probably there way too often, way too late, way too many times, probably doing nothing productive or good. But I always kind of wondered like why the bar was called that until I ran into this album. And so I was like, I have to look this up, you know. So upon further investigation, I find that in this old English folk song, there's a character named John Barleycorn, who's like kind of, I guess, the personification of barley wine and even beer and whiskey. And in this song, he suffers all sorts of like setbacks and he gets attacked and then he dies. And all the things that happen to him apparently are like supposed to correspond to the various stages of barley cultivation, such as like reaping and malting and a couple other things. So kind of a funny name for an album, but it's a great one. And this song is called Empty Pages. It's got a great jam at the end. So last song of set one, guys. Enjoy it, and we'll be right back for set two after this.